All right. Hi, guys.
Howdy.
This is Retro Millennia. We're going to do an unboxing video because I just bought a whole bunch of parts. So I'm putting together a new gaming computer for, you know, whatever I want to do and maybe some VR stuff in the future. So we'll start off with the graphics card.
This is the MSI GTX 1080. It is the successor of my card, the 980 Ti. It's rocking 8 gigabytes of GDDR5
heck yeah
video memory, which is insanity. If you were to crossfire two of these, you could.
This is already technically more powerful than the Titan, which is whatever, you know, $1,000 or whatever. And this was only $721, something like that. So $300 for more power, or $300 less for more power. So yeah, I mean, it's pretty intense stuff. So let's do this.
So while Ken's doing this, we were discussing building PCs, and he was doing a lot of research, and I sent him my entire rig build, everything I did, and what he came to find is that everything I bought was pretty much always in the top 5 or the top 10.
Right, so if I looked up like
every single thing he had.
So, quote unquote, the best length for gaming, so like the best SSD for gaming, or the best RAM for gaming, it ended up coming up with pretty much whatever he had at the moment anyways. Mm-hmm. So, you know, he's got a pretty solid rig.
So the only thing that he really has that's better than me at this point is this card, which 2 gigabytes more of video compared to mine, which my card's already a monster.
Yeah.
So it can run everything at ultra with, I just downloaded Dark Souls Prepare to Die Edition and put like 7 mods on it right away, and I'm still way above 60 frames a second.
Oh yeah,
I can. It's insanity. So this one, I can only even imagine with an extra 2 gigs of video is gonna be.
It's gonna be fun. But yeah,
it's your card, dude. I can't take the glory from this. I normally do the unboxings, but this is all you.
I wanted to wait for you to finish what you were saying.
Good girl. They want to see it. They want to see this. Lucky you. Your box isn't damaged. Mine was crushed.
Like, really?
The back of it was pinched.
Whoa. Wow, look at this. They really go fancy with the boxes.
That's pull it over here, I can show them. You can see get the exposure properly. There you go. You can see the MSI logo. It's all in like, it's like a matte black, and then you have like high gloss logo.
Oh, that's the kind of box you keep in case you want to store it, move it, you know?
The back spine of my box is just pinched a little bit on the back, which is annoying. That's where like your disk drivers and all your cables are and everything.
Don't need that, really.
Not yet. I just want to see the meat and potatoes of the whole thing. It's so big, that's your...
Thank you for purchasing an MSI product.
That's You're not welcome. Even a month old yet. It's not even a month old yet.
You gotta be careful.
It's just as big as
mine.
Wow,
this thing is heavy. Feel that.
It's the same. It's about the same weight as mine, yep.
I've never actually like held your car.
It's so gratifying to, I keep looking at the fucking side camera. It's so gratifying to hold one of those bad boys.
Man, this thing is hefty. Hefty. Real careful, like.
Do you have the actual box itself? Zero Frozer. There it is. Yeah.
Wow, nice little back plate so you don't damage anything.
Mm-hmm.
That is real nice.
Drops the card first day. So there it is on there, and I'll just bring it. And did you notice that all the teeth are covered?
Oh, wow. That's
yeah,
nice.
So they don't get damaged. So here you go, guys.
They really go
Zero Frozer.
This is nice.
Gorgeous, get that exposure.
When we put it together, I'll make sure to like wash my hands real thoroughly.
This
so when you put all the things in.
This is the cover I was talking about. And then it's got all the ports are protected as well.
Yeah, check out the back plate too.
It's got three. Ooh.
That's pretty nice.
You can see the dragon logo right there. That's pretty nice.
They make solid stuff. I really like the design of their stuff.
And I always love that their color coding is like black and red. The only thing that isn't the same throughout our entire game, our entire setup for both of our computers, because he got the same case as me,
I actually got a different one.
Oh, you did?
Yeah, you'll
no
see.
No shit.
It's
is it red?
Take? No, it's not.
It's not? Okay.
That would have been nice.
It's still a full tower though, isn't it?
It is.
Okay.
It's just slightly
looked like
different.
The same one on the outside.
Slightly different compared to your thermal take.
Okay. Yeah, mine has 3 200mm blue LED fans. They're like that big. It's insane how
huge.
Big they are.
Yeah, the case I got supports a lot of different fan types, and it's actually ready just like yours for like if you want to do water cooling and stuff like that. So
yeah, if that's any reference point of how big that card is, I'm 6 foot tall, so is Ken, and it's bigger than my hand, which is, it's obviously it's bigger than mine, but I mean, like, if it starts here, it goes to about there. It's insanity how big that thing is. That's what she said.
Oh, yeah. There we go.
So, we were just gonna make it just a graphics card unboxing, but we decided since all of his components came in today, we're gonna unbox everything for you. It's gonna be fun. So let's, I'll start handing him stuff.
Yes, I'll put this away.
A few moments later.
I don't know, we might be able to fit it. Oh, dude, maybe not.
How about, yeah, you do that.
All right.
Oh God, we're going to the hand cam now. And get ready.
Hopefully you got steady cam hands on you.
Oh, I do, don't you worry. Okay, so you can see the mouse that's recording us, well, recording cam, that's gonna sound. I'll just put it in there.
I'm cutting cards, there we go.
Just try not to smack the mouse, that's all. You can see, so this is the table we're on right now, right?
This is gonna
That's work. How tall it is from Ken's torso, if that gives you any idea how big a full tower is. These things are fantastic.
I didn't know what I was getting into with that.
No.
This thing is
Yeah.
huge. I was looking at the dimensions, comparing the one you have to this one.
Yep.
They're pretty similar.
Are they? Okay.
How do you even get this thing out?
I had to put mine on the floor and pull it out sideways.
Pull it out sideways?
I did, yep, that's what I had to do.
Is she real? Oh, maybe I can... My... Nope.
Okay, it's so going here's what... No. Turn it. So here's what we're gonna do.
I can pull it... If you get over here, if I put it on the board, we
That's
can
what
pull
I'm gonna do, yes, exactly.
So you just gotta grab your chair. This is a project. Alright, you just pull your chair out of the way.
Oh god.
Why would you stop? So yeah, you can tell it's almost as tall as the table is. Just put your fingers under there.
It's stuck on something.
Wait, you can't pull yours up?
And then we have to go like same time. Ready? Set.
Go.
Oh wait, okay.
Get my hand under it.
Okay, bam, good. Son. And nothing this else in the box.
Get that out of the
that's
way.
All that's in the box. Fucking box. Big ass box. Oh. Going back to the hand cam.
Oh, look, instructions.
Bam, those. Son. And there.
I hope that does. That's gonna be loud.
Yeah, it was a good spike on Audacity, but it's not terrible. It didn't clip, that was the important thing.
Oh boy.
This thing is so good.
And that's not standing up, that's on its side right now, just to let you guys know.
Yeah, just making that connection too.
How many hard drive bays are in this one?
A lot, I think. Actually, not as many as yours, surprisingly.
Oh,
it's
really?
Got a lot of space for other stuff.
Okay. As you guys can see, there's a light source from the right over yonder, and then there's a light source to the left. Give this a little bit better lighting for quality recording.
Oh, we already made a mess of the table.
Look at what you did. You can do it, you can do it, you can do it. I believe in you. Oh my God. What do you stuck on here? And boom, there it is.
That new computer smell.
Get a top-down view. You can see my Gibson over there.
It's got some fans already built in. Let's open this baby up.
You want to show us the backside of it first? Just rotate it the front towards. Okay, or the front. That's good too.
You get a front view.
Get a front view of that bad boy.
It's got some power. It's got the power buttons. A couple other USBs on it.
Gotta get the top for you.
You know the typical. Ooh, wow, look at. I like this. It's very sleek design. Oh, I think. Oh, wow, this is magnet. Check that out. That's weird. Like this pulls right off. And then this is just like magnet here, sticking right to the case. That's kind of nice.
Get some nice macro shot on that. You can see it's USB 3.0, 2.0, power.
Look at all the, like, you could put so many fans on this thing.
How many does it come with?
Oh, it's only got, I think it's got the front and it's got the back fan, two front fans. I don't remember what size. But you can buy more, there's so much room for putting fans.
There you go, and the backside?
Not much to look at, but there is room to like take this off, you can get some more space back there.
That side is gonna be where all your cable management is.
Right, yeah, there's a lot of space back there for that.
And here is the rear.
So they put in a lot of these, which is really nice for cable management.
The grommets, son.
So here's the fan I was talking about. They have a lot of room for PCIe cards, whatever.
Nice.
Yes.
Yeah. Quality build.
If you didn't notice this on this side too, it's got, this is room for like a fan, more fan. So I think
yours
ideally
looks taller than mine.
I think it might be a little bit taller,
but it's not as long.
No. But it has this on the bottom, which is kind of nice for airflow, I think, because you could pull in the cool air from the bottom and then push out the hot air at the top, because typically, you know, hot air rises, so you just go with that. Get the hot air from like the power supply, the graphics card,
push it right out
the top. So if you want, if you had like, I feel like if you had a radiator for like a cooling system, you'd want to put it at the top, because then the hot air just goes right out. You're not pushing it through the computer.
Do you want to do a 180 rotation so we can see the inside of it? Just like take
thumb. Oh, yes. Yeah, I was going to open it up.
Take those thumb screws off. You can see the plastic still on cellophane, but that's
let's take that off.
Can you get it off? That's a there we go. That's the outside one.
Oh.
That sound. It's such a gratifying sound. And then if, let me get a macro shot of that really fast. You got, there are thumb screws on the back here.
That are pretty tight. Yeah, those are, there are four of them actually.
Let's see.
Oh, that's for the bottom thing. So you got that. You got this. Oh, this one's not as tight. Just that top one.
They don't come out, they just loosen. Oh, okay, your ears come out.
Typically they come out. Yours is a sliding open one, right?
It kind of. It operates on a hinge.
Yeah, mine's, this one's not a hinge.
Oh, okay.
It's the one where you have to completely take it off.
You're just gonna hear me in the background the whole time, and everything else is just gonna be you, like right in front of the mic.
Oh, yeah.
Just wait, I'm waiting for you to smack it too. I'm just one hit, that's all it's gonna be. Look how close he is to the mic, guys.
Oh no, I think there's another screw in there, actually.
Is there?
There's a couple other screws that I gotta take off.
No
I think that's
way.
Just for when they ship it.
Oh, snap.
It's so it doesn't come off, and then you take them off, and then you just keep the thumb screws in there.
Okay, well, I can just do this then. I can just get a macro shot so you can see the rubber grommets in the back. You got them here.
I can take
here.
Off the bottom.
Oh, snap. You can see the hard drive bays here, and there are some ports up here for optical drives, so your disk drives or Blu-ray drives. It's looking like there's open space here, and that's where you could add more hard drive bays if you so desire.
Yeah.
And then there's enough space on the bottom
so
here.
This is perfectly set up for fans and putting in your power supply down here. So
it's a little different than mine. Yeah, that's crazy.
It's got these and these.
Those are the same rubber grommets that I just
showed.
Yeah,
so that you can decide if you want the power supply up here or down here.
Yep.
It works for both. Well, down here, rather. I guess is where you put that.
It's a solid case. There's a solid looking case.
Actually, do you have a screwdriver? I'd like to take that off.
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah, set that up.
Can't see, you can only see the top.
Just look at this.
What do you need, a Phillips or a flat?
It's a Phillips, yeah. Just check that out. That's the size of this thing. It's as large as my torso and more.
Here, let me back out and I can show.
Just check that. Like, here's where my stomach starts.
Yep.
And then here's where the case.
Ken's 6 foot just like me, so it's
that's an intense rig. Like, this is not going to be easy to carry.
No,
well, I guess
not at all.
Well, right now, because there's nothing in it, it's pretty easy.
All right, so we need
that one and this one.
Oh, typical thermal take screws.
Oh, yeah. You gotta really push them so you don't strip them, because they're
black screw. Oh,
really tight in there. Oh, are they?
Yeah, nice. Well, this is a magnet tip screwdriver. Which I'm probably the latter of those two, to be honest.
I don't know why they have the ones that you can loosen easily, and the ones.
Because you probably will only put one set in. If you plan on changing components in and out pretty quickly. Boom.
I dropped it.
And back to the hand cam.
Let's see that
right there. All right, so now you can get a freaking awesome
shot at that.
So
you got the
hard drive bays.
This is where you can put like your CD drive, whatever. And you can see the fans in there, all the wire management that you can do.
Now the cables that are already in there are the IO for like the power button, the USBs that are on board to the case,
the fan controls. There's
that's
a bunch of other
hardwire
other parts that you'll need for doing some of that.
Yeah, hardware bag just for
right
goodies.
Yeah.
And there is his Thermaltake case. Thermaltake.
Check it.
Very solid brand. It's the only cases I've ever had.
They're not like too designy, which is they're very just like they're somewhat basic, but they do the job well.
Definitely.
So next on the agenda after the tower is the mega box of everything else.
It's okay, Ken. You can just it'll do its just fucking put stab it in, man.
Just put it in. Fine. Trying to be gentle.
I don't want you to be gentle. That's not what I asked for. Thanks.
Oh, wow. You didn't ask for it.
God. All right. Look at all these bubbles. Oh, my God. I got to do a thing.
Oh, you're going to destroy the mic.
They're all popped. No. Yeah. Okay, we're good. Wow, that
did my look at all this.
Okay. I had to walk away from the mouse because otherwise I would have clipped really bad. There's so much stuff.
Like a kid in a candy store.
Box in a box. Uh-huh.
Yes.
A box in a box.
There was a box in that box.
Okay. All right. Okay. What is this?
Holy receipt for everything.
This power
supply. Let's see what we got here. We got an MSI X99 SLI Plus. That is the same motherboard as me. He's got a power supply. Is an EVGA 850 Platinum.
This thing is
dirty
huge.
Bastard. He has an Intel Core i7-5820K 6-core clocked at 3.3 gigahertz.
Wow, this is so light.
Yeah. It's fantastic. Don't worry, guys. We'll get everything in a nice close shot. That's the processor in my hand.
Same one. Got the
same one. You bought a keyboard? You didn't tell me you bought a keyboard?
That's right.
I didn't get down.
I went all out. I just don't have the mouse yet.
You bought a 4 terabyte?
Yeah. Ooh, I figure I'm gonna need it.
Dirty girl. All
right. Need it. Look at that.
I need it.
How do you?
Oh, we bought an optical drive.
Bubble.
Whoa, this isn't like...
That's like less than 20 bucks.
So this isn't like like your typical bubble. This is like hard plastic filled with like compressed air.
Oh wow, this is intense.
What brand is that?
Logitech. Logitech does really well with keyboards and mice, I found.
You got a gaming keyboard, didn't you? Mechanical one?
Yeah,
of course. All right.
Of course.
Box number two. Down we go. Look at all the goodies.
All right, let's pull the chairs back.
Sling. Who needs sling? Piss off with your advertising and such. Oh. All right, where's your RAM? Oh, it's over there. Okay, so what's in this box?
SSD?
Oh no, you're 4 terabyte.
Oh wow, they did the same thing.
Come, here it is, 4 terabytes at 7,200 RPMs, unless you got a 10,000.
I don't think so.
Okay, we'll find out. Next time on Dragon Ball Z!
Dragon Ball Z! Oh no, this box is kind of...
Hardcore!
Alright.
Lots of deja vu. Oh, I should probably check what the camera did.
Yeah, we just have everything being locked. This is not what we need first.
We'll set it right there. That'll work.
Can you see the whole table?
Not all of it, but most of it. We don't need it because we're only going to be doing one thing at a time. Wow.
That's what I'm trying to do. Yeah.
That box was dirty. Got my cloth all dirty. Whatever. I don't
yeah.
Care.
It's because we laid it on your floor and then brought it up to the table.
Holy crap. Your power supply is heavy, dude.
Oh, I noticed that.
So right. There you go, guys, is the platinum rated 850 watt SLI plus ready power supply. That's a mouthful.
You said platinum, right?
Yep, it's platinum.
So, if you don't know, there are, I think, five? There's bronze, silver, gold, platinum, and titanium. I don't know why titanium comes last, but that's how it is. So platinum is the second highest rating, and that's in terms of how well the power supply actually gives power to the rest of it and how consistent it is.
Isn't titanium stronger than platinum? So maybe they're going by strength rating.
I guess that makes sense then, if that's the case. I'm not too familiar with my metal.
So what this also means is that because it's SLI ready, I had mentioned cross-firing earlier, and cross-firing is basically you're taking one graphics card and another graphics card and you're making them work in sync.
Yeah.
So they're basically acting like one mega graphics card and you get twice the power. And unless your power supply is SLI plus ready, rather, SLI ready, it cannot support that feature. And one, it won't have enough ports to do it, and two, if you tried doing it, you would...
Right, you wouldn't have enough power.
You wouldn't have enough power, so you could blow your entire computer, which would be a nightmare. So make sure if you're going to be cross-firing or if you're looking into cross-firing, you get at least gold certified SLI Plus ready power supply.
Yeah, you also got, you got to make sure that, like, this is 850, so you gotta, you have to make sure that the wattage is high enough to support both the graphics cards, because they do tend to really up the wattage. A lot of them tend to have a recommended recommended like wattage number for how big your power supply should be.
Oh yeah.
I'm not sure that they always recommend for if you're gonna crossfire them though. So that's something you have to look at more deeply into. I've never actually personally crossfired anything, so maybe I'll do that in the future. And I'm not sure like how that all works, so that's something you'd have to research.
So let's
put it up. I think I put the knife over there.
You did. May I?
Sure. Cool. Go for it. It's just, the plastic part is always a tricky one.
Without cutting the box.
I usually get it on these edges.
There we go. Bam.
Ho ho ho, platinum.
Oop.
Look at that box. Maybe it's just the box that's heavy.
Doubt it.
Doubt it.
Garbage, get that out of here. Alright, so.
Garbage. Oh, great. Another one.
Another one. Thank goodness. Oh, dare they. And try not to puncture your box.
Yeah. So, as far as, like, I don't know. I don't actually remember what my current power supply is, but EVGA tends to do some high quality stuff in terms of just anything computer wise. So like their graphics cards also tend to be very well built. MSI seems to be really on top of their game recently, so that's what I've been going with for a lot of these things. But EVGA makes some solid graphics cards and
definitely
power supplies as well.
And Corsair makes a really good power supply as well. So
yeah, and that's what you have, right?
Yep, Corsair and EVGA are the two companies to really look at when you're doing something like this. What?
Wow, maybe it is the box that's heavy.
That's
oh, it's because it's
awesome.
Got all the cables.
It's got its own carrying bag. That's awesome.
Dang.
Oh my god. It smells like chlorine.
That's a weird smell.
You got a little...
Look at all, it's because it's fully modular too. Fully modular as in, like a lot of the power supplies, you get them and it's got all the cables already managed for you and you just have to figure out where to put them. Mm-hmm. But this, it has each individual cable wrapped up. So you can plug in only the ones you need when you need them. So if you add a Crossfire graphics card, you can just plug in that when you need it.
Like this.
Otherwise, you don't need it plugged in.
I believe this is your Crossfire cable right here.
I believe so. And this one's the one you actually plug in.
You have so many cables.
I know. I was actually worried when I was looking at it, whether it was gonna come with the cables.
In the moment of truth, it's got its own little bag. Oh my god, I wish mine was that fancy. Now I'm gonna have to set my game up. Stop making me feel bad about myself. That smells like chlorine, like straight up smells like chlorine.
I love how like well designed the boxes are even. Like nice, this is a box I'll keep.
It's a solid book. I keep all of my computer components.
Yeah, same.
And
you never know when you're gonna need it.
Velcro.
Look, there's the modular part. You can
I'll get a nice
close-up
nice
view
on that.
Of that. That's where you plug it. Holy cow, this
that is all of your ports. Oop, sorry. That is all of your ports. That is everything you will plug into, like your motherboard, your cards, everything will go into that.
Man, oh man.
And EVG, there it is, 850P2.
What the heck?
And then, you know, you just got your little power and all. You can see all the components inside the grate. And then it's Mega Fan on the bottom. You got EVGA's logo displayed. And then you've got all of its ratings on the side. So I believe it shows like your resistance and everything. Yeah, it's got your combined wattage, max output, DC, AC, all that good jazz.
Man,
that no one really needs to look
solidly
at.
Solidly built.
It's heavy.
It's not it. So the box is really heavy. This isn't actually as heavy as you would think.
That's probably like six or seven.
The cables really do add up quite a bit of weight. They're really thick cables. Like they have the mesh around them to keep them safe and secure. So, you know.
So. That's where everything stems from. That is the...
This is the power central.
Okay. People are gonna see this video as an MSI 1080 unboxing and they're gonna be like, why is it like 45 minutes? And just be like, well, the card came out like the first 3 minutes, so we didn't...
Well, guys, well, if you want, we can go over that again.
Yeah, right? I'll probably just put a timestamp in the beginning of it and just be like, okay, so this is where the card comes out, so you don't have to complain about
this
it.
This is where the card comes out.
And this is the rest of the computer that Ken's building. Whoop-ah!
Putting it back in the box is always not as fun as taking it out.
That is so what he and she said. Both of them.
They think? Were so neatly organized, and now I'm just like shoving it in there. I realize what I said.
So, there we go.
Nice.
What, best. What say you? We have motherboard, we have cooling fan.
I say motherboard.
Motherboard?
Makes more sense.
Oh, I missed some cables. You want to pass these?
Oh, yeah. And you missed the screws and the ports, too.
Oh, man.
You ruined it!
Man, oh, man, oh, man.
It's game over now. And you probably want this in there.
Yeah. Darn it. It's just not going
to
fit.
Let's just put some more components in front of me because I just want to feel like I actually have money for once and not lie to myself every time.
He's got money. I mean, he just did it over time. I just did it all at once.
I did mine over like a month and a half period. His, yeah, that's what like my box was all damaged right there. Like the corners all kinked up. But all my webcam is sitting on my gaming box right now because I couldn't get a high enough angle. Yeah, I've already unboxed one of these, so this is just all like, him.
Oh, I've done this before. I'm experienced in this area.
Yeah, and all of your drivers and everything are underneath there. It's just books and stuff like that. So this
I never know where to hold these things. Like,
oh yeah, it's really awkward. Cause like I always just like put them like on my palm, and I'm just like, and like awkwardly like carry them around like this.
Come on.
So this is the MSI X99 SLI Plus, and the SLI is the cross firing of the graphics cards. And this board was basically the number one rated motherboard for our processor, which we will get to in a second. I would suggest not putting it on the,
yeah,
on there.
It's gonna stick to that. So you can kind of see that.
Mm-hmm. Okay, you can see that. So this is where the processor goes. There's a little cover right here. Underneath there is a female receiving end. And this is where your RAM goes. This is where more RAM goes. It supports DDR4, which is fantastic, super fast. This is where your graphics card and any PCI stuff goes. And then if you just want to rotate this up a little, this is where your I/O, so you have all USB 3.0s here, and you have your sound. It's not a sound card because you don't have one. He didn't buy one, but it's just the onboard sound, which works perfectly fine.
It's pretty nice. It's not
and
bad.
You have two USB 2.0s with a. I don't remember what these ports are called. Where the
it's the mouse keyboard port. You know, from the olden days when they used to plug in using that kind of thing.
Who uses those anymore? It's all USB at this point now, isn't it?
And here's the awkward part, trying to get it back in that thing.
Mm-hmm. Ow. Rolling the dice. Rolling the dice with drinking a brisk by
You dick.
It won't get hurt, don't worry. Hashtag brisk sponsor us. I'm keeping you in business with how much brisk I buy. Let's be real right now.
Darn it.
You got it there, guy?
Yeah.
You gonna make it?
It over this last pump.
My lump, my lovely lady lumps.
Alright.
So you thinking PSU next?
Let's do it.
Makes the most sense. Not PSU, we already did that. Fucking CPU.
Oh yeah, you said PSU.
PSU, that's power supply. CPU is processor. I already opened this to you, so I won't do that to you. So this is the 5820K that Ken's gonna. This is the processor. This is the brain of it, basically. This is what makes it all run. That's the map, that's the brain. The PSU is the power, and I guess you could call the graphics card the eyes. It's what makes this, what makes all the videos look nice and everything. And 4K gaming on that card.
What the ball?
It's gonna be solid. What'd you do? Did you break it? You gotta put your tab.
Close.
There you go. Gotta put your tabs in, man.
Tab it in.
I can't wait to test out that keyboard. I just want to feel the keys so bad. So I mean,
just gonna go over
there. Don't really need to show off your.
No, yeah, my optical drive.
It's an optical drive or a hard drive. Everyone knows what a hard drive looks like. It is a 4 terabytes at, I'm going to guess, 7200.
Yeah, I think so.
I can't imagine you'd go any slower than that. Who would want to at this point in 2016?
Unless I made a mistake.
Dated.
But it's a Western Digital Black Edition, so I think those are all the
performance hard drive.
Yeah.
It doesn't actually give the hard drive speed on it. That's kind of funny.
I can look it
up. I mean, it says 64 megabytes of cache, which, okay. La-di-da, I guess.
La-di-da.
Just put you back in your little sleeve here.
Oh boy.
Yep.
There's so tiny.
Yeah, there's not a lot to it.
Way smaller than the AMD thing I had before.
Put that over here. And the disk drive.
This is my first Intel CPU.
We were both AMD for a long time, and
because it's cheaper, they actually do have pretty good performance for quite a bit cheaper. But if you're doing serious stuff, you
kind of have to switch to Intel.
And
no doubt about
Intel's,
it.
Intel just mops the floor. Like, I compared this to the 9590. That's like AMD's top of the line.
I won't take it out because, you know.
No, God, no.
Because you don't want to mess that up by by mistake.
I do have the little wipes to make sure there's no fingerprints.
The wipes, and we got to put the thermal paste on there, so that's going to be fun.
Arctic.
We have to really wash the hands. Make sure.
Yeah.
You don't want any dust specks on this thing, because that can affect performance. Interesting tidbit. I actually learned this in one of my classes. I think I might have told you a little bit about it, but. So you know how like a line of CPUs has like different gigahertz? Mm-hmm. So like you can get 3.3.
That's what that one's at, yeah.
And then like the other ones in that same line have different ones and they're more expensive, mm-hmm. depending on how fast they are.
Like,
but they're all the same number of cores. They have different gigahertz. So the reason for that is, this is what I was told by my teacher anyways, is that when they're making them in the factory on the line, the difference in that like gigahertz is due to like any dust particles or things that happen during manufacturing. So like they'll go through the line, they'll all be created in the same exact way, but then they'll be tested afterwards. So if they fall in a certain range, then that's what they sell for. So like this card is exactly the same as a faster card in the same line. But it's clocked at only 3.3 because that's all it could handle because of whatever happened during manufacturing. Kind of
like any resistance, yeah, or anything.
Right.
Like that.
So
now,
if
I didn't say that, that was just my professor. So don't blame me.
So yeah, I mean, that's what he said. I believe it. It makes sense because you get so fine. Any small difference in something inside here could cause quite a bit of change in performance. It makes sense, and that's why they're so much more expensive.
If you were to touch the processor and you have an oil on there,
yeah,
you could thermal throttle the shit out of your processor if you don't clean it off, or you could just fry it all together.
Yeah,
if you touch the processor and then don't put
careful.
Like the thermal paste. When you put thermal paste on, you don't want anything more than like a size of rice on your.
Yeah, it's amazing how much
you
it
need
like
moves such
around.
A small amount on there, and then when you just push the processor or the cooling fan onto it,
because it gets so tight on there.
It's so tight, it just squeezes it right out.
And yeah, because if you put too much, it'll overflow and
it'll start leaking, and then your components will get all grilled.
Like it'll be hard to like wipe off. You have the potential to have other mistakes. He's looking at something over
the
here.
M2.
The M2. Oh, the M.2?
So, I have a SSD. Samsung 850 EVO 250GB solid state drive. This is like.
Words, blah.
So, this is just a 4TB standard moving parts hard drive. It has an actual disk that spins to write it.
Solid state. Which is very slow, which is also something I learned about in that same class.
A solid state means it has no moving parts. Everything is, it's just nothing. There's no disk, there's no nothing in it. And he got an upgraded version of a solid state that's what brand is it?
I can't get this close. Anyways.
D-Nan? What is that?
What are you looking at?
Oh, it is Samsung. Okay, Samsung, he got an M.2, which is like an upgraded version of it, basically. It's, instead of...
It plugs directly into the motherboard.
Right, and it gives even faster speeds. And then there's one above that, even. There's one more version.
Yes, and I don't remember what
it is. And it's little bitty. It's like a little stick. And it's ridiculous.
Yeah.
And
I mean, this one thing's pretty small anyways. Like, it's about the same size as like a RAM. It plugs in differently, though. So there are actually, I think, two types of this. You can have it... dang it. So, yeah. You can plug it in via... It can work via SATA or via PCIe type power. So if you have it SATA, then it... can't go as fast. That's why they were trying to do this type of SSD in the first place, is to get get past the SATA barrier, essentially, because it was causing it to not be as fast.
And basically what SATA is, it's cable plugged in. SATA is from a cable to a board. But
yep.
That, if it's plugged in directly, there's no buffer between a cable. It's whatever the chips can perform at. And
right,
that's
because
why
it's closer to where it's needed.
Mm-hmm.
Because SATA can only travel so fast. PCIe can travel much faster.
Computer building 101.
Yes.
Very basic stuff, but I mean, you can... not saying the concept, like,
we're not saying you're dumb, guys.
No, I'm saying that, like, we're covering, like, we're saying what it is we're saying it on a surface level. We're not going ridiculously in-depth of how it works.
Yeah.
It's basically just SATAs are cables, and...
This thing is 80.
That is...
Look at that.
That is ridiculous. So, that's my finger. That gives you any indication. That's itty bitty.
That thing, so we showed the motherboard. right near where the PCIe slots were, where you put in your graphics card. This goes in right next to those. So it's gonna be
that's gonna be so fast, dude.
I mean, it's only 256 gigabytes, but that's all you really need for an SSD, right? You don't need a whole lot of space if you're putting your operating system, maybe a couple programs.
And you're putting 10 on this, aren't you?
Yes.
What size is that? 256.
Okay. Yeah, it's only 256.
And I mean, we can open this if you want, but I don't think we really need to.
This is the RAM.
This is your memory. This is what helps make it run. I don't really know how to explain it. Just it helps make it run quickly.
Yeah, it buffers the data basically. Like we could go in depth. So the CPU has.
There's multiple levels.
It's actually got several layers of like essentially RAM inside of it, so that when you're running the program, it stores the data. So this is like another level. So it can use that to then send to the CPU and back. And when a program is done running, it clears whatever it needs for the RAM.
I'm gonna have to find 40 minutes worth of music. It's gonna be ridiculous.
Well, I mean, you'll have some cuts, so you know.
Oh yeah, yeah, yeah. Some jump cuts, not a whole lot.
All right. I guess so the next RAM. Is the fan. This isn't too fancy, but
it is nice. It does a very good job. It's like literally the most popular air fan cool on the.
So the yeah, I mean this is air cooling. There's also water cooling, but that's a lot more expensive.
That and
it takes up a lot of space.
And if you're not overclocking, and so what overclocking means is basically for anyone that doesn't know.
So like we were talking with the 3.3, you can make it go faster.
Yeah, 3.3, you're cranking up that number to make it perform beyond what its factory safe settings. I mean,
the 3.3 is guaranteed.
Yeah, and then when you overclock, you can find stable numbers. But you have to mess around with it, and like I think the highest that ours have been clocked at so far is 4.4 as a stable processor. But if you start overclocking, you need liquid cooling. It is mandatory for how hot it gets, because you're pushing the processor so much harder, and you're driving more electricity and more current into it to turn up the heat.
And the reason you can overclock is because of what I was talking about before, because there is like when I said there are like potential bad problems in the manufacturing, so they can guarantee 3.3, but it can potentially still go faster. But 3.3 is the most stable one that they find for the card if it had problems. So you can potentially go 3.4 if there was enough mistakes to make it go below the other level, but not enough that you can't overclock, if that makes sense.
No. And with this one, this is the same.
This thing is huge.
Mm-hmm, this is the same cooling fan that I have on mine. I just suggested you get it because it's the number one on Newegg, and I mean it's like the most popular. It's a nice size fan. It's not bad. It's this 120 millimeter, right? I think it is. The specs are on the side right there.
Yes.
Yeah, 120. Yep. And that's the diameter of that. And my CPU idles around 40, 42 degrees Celsius, which is perfectly fine. And when you're putting it under heavy stress, like when I'm exporting video through Premiere or any what I'll be doing after I'm editing this video, essentially.
Yeah.
It goes at most 60 degrees, which I have my emergency shutoff set at like 70 or 75.
I mean, 60 is really not that bad. It's fairly standard for higher workloads, I think.
Mm-hmm.
So your cooling system should probably be able to handle going up to 60.
And I mean, realistically, as long as I'm not getting any thermal throttling, I'm not too concerned about burning out the processor. I'm sure it's been tested under extreme situations. They have to make sure that it can run at a certain temperature. Like, here's where they say don't go beyond, and this is where it'll actually break. So like summer, probably around like 80 degrees is when they're like, you really shouldn't go above 80.
No, because we're talking Celsius.
Yeah, we're not talking Fahrenheit.
So in Celsius, that's quite high.
It's only 20 degrees in Celsius away from the boiling point, which is 212 degrees in Fahrenheit.
So yeah, you got
Microsoft, bring me with him. I understand everything. Just let me work with him.
Let's do this.
All right, and here we have a mechanical keyboard. This is
RGB adjustable LEDs, all that.
La-di-da, my laptop can do that too. It's not mechanical, but I can still put all the lights on.
Yeah.
Put all the lights on it. For anybody that doesn't know, I have an MSI Dominator GT72 Pro.
Why did I cut the side?
Is that the bottom?
I cut both sides. You don't really need to cut both sides. Is this upside down? It is upside down.
No, it's not. That's totally the top.
This is the top. Yeah, so I was holding it upside down.
Oh, I thought you meant like you were pulling it out from the bottom.
Oh, no, that side. Doesn't matter.
You struggling there, guy? You got it?
There's a hole. What a bunch of dicks.
Dick!
You're cutting it.
I'm sorry! Okay, so...
Not coming out real nice.
Oh, boy. Wow, look at that box. So...
That's a bit much.
That's a little heavy. So that's the Logitech, right? Logitech logo?
Yeah, Logitech.
And there it is over there. That's pretty cool.
G910.
It's all you, Ryan. This is yours. Looks like something like got pushed in the corner because it even hit the blue on the inside box. Oh, that's nice. And I want you to get the first click. No.
Wow. Solid. That Can you hear that?
That's dry.
Wow. This...
Ooh, whoa, those feel weird. What are those? M1, M2, M3, M4?
Yeah, I think it's... You can set presets for these buttons or something.
And,
those
and that's how you know it's a gaming keyboard.
Yeah.
If you're playing League. Playing League or you're playing...
Because you've got, like, up here, you've got extra buttons.
Let's pull it over for him.
So you got extra buttons here, I think, for changing presets.
Yep.
These are the extra buttons that you can program yourself. They're not usual.
Yeah, there's
G1, 2, 3, 4, 5,
and
blah,
then
blah, blah.
4, no, sorry, 6, 7, 8, and 9. And then you have other. You've got your volume control right here. That's cool.
That's nice. Oh, wow. That
feels
interesting.
A little,
I didn't even see that.
So, that, in my opinion, that feels a little flimsy. It feels a little
right. It just
little thin. Doesn't feel.
How does it like even just like it doesn't stop?
It's probably a laser. A laser that reads which way it rolls.
We'll see how that works.
Yep.
This will be nice.
Clicky.
I like it.
Anything underneath it that's important?
I don't think so. You can adjust this has adjustment. Like this is an additional front adjustment thing.
Oh,
so
that's
you can
nice.
Change how it sits on your wrist.
All right. So to recap, we're gonna put paper. I mean, I could just list off the parts. So, if you guys, I'll probably put like a little list somewhere. I don't know where the camera ends. So, somewhere over here, of all the parts you got. So, I'll try to make something follow your hand the whole time. That'll be a nightmare. That'd be so much keyframing. So, he has an MSI X99 SLI Plus motherboard.
Yes.
Fantastic. Yep. He has the new MSI GTX 1080. Graphics card.
Yeah, Gaming X version.
Gaming
There'll probably
important.
Be newer ones in the future. I think they're planning on doing a Gaming Z version.
And they'll do a 1080 Ti. You know they
oh,
will.
Oh, for sure.
That's what MSI's signature for. But, I mean, just the Ti, 980 Ti in general. Or Ti
I mean, that's
model
a beast
in
card already, so this is going to be interesting to see how this one performs.
It'll probably go up to like 12 gigs or some garbage like that. You're struggling there, guy.
Yes. Lift the front piece.
I can't.
There we go.
Hold on. Okay, now go. It's because
yes.
the blue box is gone. Okay, so we got that. We got he has the graphics card. He has an i7-5820K 6-core clocked at 3.3 gigahertz.
Yes.
He has an EVGA or EVGA, however you want to say it.
I've never heard that.
Yeah, that's what I say.
Okay, cool.
850-watt power supply, fully modular, platinum rating.
Platinum.
SLI Plus ready power supply. The Cooler Master Hyper 212 Evo 120mm fan.
Yep.
He has a 4TB Western Digital Black Edition.
Yep.
I don't like how you said black.
clocked.
We're going to say it's 7200, even though it doesn't say on here, because that's...
I'll give it a quick look up.
It's either that or the 10,000 version. He's got just a standard, the most popular Asus
it's
optical
like
drive.
It's literally $20.
Yeah, it is, and it's the same one I have in mind, and it works great.
A CD, DVD, and... I think both reader and writer for both of those.
Mm-hmm. It is. Yeah, it's the same one I have. It works great. It writes in iTunes. If you import a CD, it writes at like 30x30. It's fantastic.
Yeah.
We got DDR4 clocked at 3,000, 16 gigs, 2 8-gigabyte sticks. And the Samsung 256 gig M.2 solid state drive.
Yes, 950 Pro specifically.
All right, guys, thanks for sticking around 51 minutes, and we will see you later.
Yeah.
Peace. See ya.